Hello, I'm gonna teach you how to set up port forwarding for the popular server mod called Bucket for Minecraft. Now, you first set up your port forwarding, you need to know what router you have. So, that's basically on your router, on the back side or the front side or the bottom, basically, you have to figure out the model number. And then, you go to a website called portforwarding.com. I'll have the link in the description. And this is a pretty good website for stuff not like stuff that's not even for Minecraft, but other stuff too. So at this website you'll have all these links, all these like router model numbers. Now you have to click on the model number that you have. So I have a TP link, so I'm gonna click on this link right here, and now this will take me to skip the advertisement. And this will take me to a page with all just basically how-tos to do all of these. And if you go down to Minecraft server. Click on this. Now this will tell you for your specific router how to set up port forwarding. It will take you step by step, easy to do, and it's not hard. You know, just look at this. It has pictures and everything. And they also have a port checker tool that you can download, which is really handy. It basically, you put the port number here, you check which protocol you want to do, and check me, and it'll tell you if it's good or not. So that's good, so you don't have to start up your server to see if it's working or not. Just use this program. If you have Windows, of course. So that's simple, basically. And when you set that up, if you go into your bucket folder that you made in the previous video, go to server properties, and over here, your server IP. Now you're not gonna put your IP that everyone else sees. It's the you're gonna put the IP that you see. So to do that, in Windows at least, you go to command prompt and type in ipconfig. Press enter. And you get all this data. If you go up to your if you're connected through Ethernet, you'll go to the Ethernet adapter local area connection, or if you're connected to wireless LAN, you go over here. But what you'll see is your IPv4 address or IPv5 address depending on your router and stuff. But you'll have this IP address is basically specific to your computer, not like in your router's eye. So basically you're gonna put this into here. And then the server port you'll leave normal. And then yeah, when you do put that in, you save, you're good. And this is after you set up your router, after you port forward your router. And now there's two different IP addresses. There's a static and dynamic. The dynamic is what it's mostly common with households. It basically changes your local IP address if you can reset your computer and stuff like that. It changes it every so often. So then you'll have to change it in the server properties if you want for people to connect right. So it is a hassle, but that's what you have to do. But if you have a dynamic IP address, which you do have to pay extra or get a business class, it will never change and it'll stay constant. So you won't have to, you know, change it in the server properties to make it work. If you close your servers, if you close and open your servers and stuff. So, and for other people to connect to your server, you have to go, just go to whatismyipaddress.com. I'll have the link in the description, and I'll tell you your IP address. Now, this is what you have to give to your friends to connect, for them to connect to you. They have to put this, right, and then colon 25565. So if I just, so basically what they have to put is your IP address. That's what they have to put. So when they do that, they'll connect to your server. And if you set up your server right, you'll be getting no errors whatsoever. I'll show you how it looks if you don't set it up right. And remember, your IP address may be different than mine. Okay, so when you open it up and you don't have it right, it'll say starting server, and then it'll say server to this IP address, and it'll still fail to bind port. And then, you know, it's like perhaps the server is already running on that port or whatever. So this is the inner error message. So basically, you have to put the right IP address at this current time. And now this may be different for other IP, for other computers. Other ones, you don't have to change this all that often. It's a dynamic, and you'll just have to keep it a constant number. Or you may have to change it like I do. And if you don't even have a router, some people do, what you have to do, what you have to put over here, is this. This is what you have to put. If you do not have a router. And that's how you connect and they connect. And also how you connect is you could connect through how they, how your friends do, or the people who connect to your server. Or you could put this IP address, then colon 25565. Either works for yourself, not for anyone else. They have to put this IP address. Also, if you go to whatismyipaddress.com, it'll tell you what everything is, what's all the static IP address, dynamic IP address.